In this video, we're given the total current flowing through a circuit, and then the main goal of the problem is to find this unknown resistance capital R. In the left branch of the circuit, we're given an ideal EMF of 4.5 volts. That's in series with an internal resistance of 1 ohm, and that makes the potential difference between nodes A and B the terminal voltage of the power source. So in part A, that's what we're finding. In part B, we'll find the current through the central branch of the circuit, and then in part C, we'll finally compute this unknown resistance. So to get the terminal voltage of the battery, if I'm being formal about this, I can say that VA, the potential at node A, plus the 4.5 volts for the ideal EMF, minus the voltage drop across the internal resistance, well, that's given by Ohm's law, it's I times R, that's all equal to the potential at node B. Then what we mean by this notation VAB is actually the difference VB minus VA. So I subtract VA from both sides and then simplify this expression, 4.5 minus 0.784 times 1. When I run the numbers on this, I get a terminal voltage of 3.716 volts. Now, it's not necessary to be that formal about computing the terminal voltage. I could just say, well, here's my ideal power source, 4.5 volts, minus the drop over the internal resistance, which is given by IR. So just 4.5 minus IR. In part B, we want to get the current through the 10 ohm resistor, and we have the potential difference across that resistor because the voltage at the high side of that 10 ohm resistor is the same VB, and at the low side, I'm connected to ground, but just more generally speaking, that's my VA because it's connected directly by wire to node A. So I have the same exact potential difference of 3.716 volts across that 10 ohm resistor. I apply Ohm's law to this. I'll write it as I equals V over R. And I have a 3.716 volt potential difference over a 10 ohm resistor, which gives me a current of 0.3716 amps. Now, the whole reason this is useful is that it allows me to compute how much current is flowing in the right branch of the circuit. We had a total of 0.784 amps flowing in this circuit. We just figured out how much flows down this middle branch when the current splits. That's 0.37 1 6 amps, and the leftover amount is the amount flowing through the right branch. I'll just call that IR. So IR is just the total amount of current minus the amount that went down the center branch, and this gives me 0.4124 amps flowing down that right branch. Now, the reason this is useful for finding our unknown resistance R is that I have the potential difference across that right branch. It's that same 3.716 volts, because again, we're just directly connected by wire to nodes A and B at the top and bottom of this branch. So I have the potential difference across it. I have the total current through it. That allows me to get the total resistance of that branch. And then if I just subtract the 5 ohms out of that, I'll have the resistance capital R. So working through it somewhat formally, I'm going to use Ohm's law for this. V equals IR, and the potential difference across this symbolically is VAB. And the total current through it, I call that I sub R, so I'll write it symbolically for a second. And then my total resistance is going to be capital R plus the 5-ohm resistor. So dividing by the current, IR, and then subtracting the 5 ohms, I can solve for my capital R. And we plug the numbers in for the terminal voltage, that was 3.716, and the current in the right-hand branch, that was 0.4124. And we're going to subtract 5 ohms from that at the end. And I get a resistance of 4.01 ohms. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.